It's not how much we carve, but where we carve. And I think this is a huge misperception about carving and trying to get kids to carve all the time. Carving is an element that's part of skiing. And it's a result of putting a lot of skills together. And that's as far as a reality of what we're trying to do. One of the things I think we have to take a look at before we actually dive into this video is starting to understand the idea that you can arc or you can carve, and those are not the same. So what we see in an athlete, say, when you do railroad track turns, so simply say a flat hill, just rolling from edge to edge, using your feet, legs, whatever, that is arcing. That is not carving. And the difference between the two is that in carving, there's a lot of pressure, and it's actually for a very short period of time relative to the whole turn. So arcing, it's pretty simple to roll from edge to edge and allow the ski to arc without significant pressure. And carving is a lot of pressure. It's a short period of time, and you're bending the ski. This is a shot of Michaela at the World Championships. I really like this. It's got mostly to do because of the angle of the camera, and the light allows us to see some things. So if we're going to take a look at the how much time she spends carving versus how much time she spends not carving. And you've got to pay particular attention to the outside ski, which is her left ski right now. So that frame to that frame is where this outside ski starts to bend. Up until that, she was drifting. So at this point, she's beginning to carve. You can look at the ski tip. It's just ahead of the gate. So if we bring the skis to there, she's now traveled a full ski length. You with me? Give me a thumbs up if you're with me at this point. All right. So only traveled one full ski length. We're going to go a little bit farther. She's now done carving. That's it. She's traveled at most two full ski lengths. So now, all this time, she is not carving. Inside ski starts to arc, still not carving. Watch the outside ski. Right there, it bends. So from this time all the way back to here, that entire span, she is not carving. And the reason that's important is there tends to be a misconception of how much we carve. She gets across the hill because of the pressure she created earlier in the fall line. So carving, here is the acceleration phase. And the important part, and we'll talk a little bit later about the ideas, it's not how much, how fast you go, it's really about how little you slow down. Carving, she's done with the carve. So again, we're talking about two ski lengths. Carve is done. At this point, she's beginning to flatten the ski. And now she's traveling through the space, drifting. Look at the left ski again. And this is a delay, so it's got a lot longer turn to it. Right there. So between those two frames is where she begins what I refer to as pick up the carve. It's a little bit longer turn, so a few more ski lengths, but now she's done carving. So this entire time, she's accelerating down the hill. So I'm interested to know what she does, or I'm interested to know what you think she does from here to there, to when she finally re-engages the ski.
On a limb, I'll take a chance here.
Thank you.
It looks like she's rotating to get her skis around the other side of her body, and she's almost just falling down the hill. She's not actually, almost the skis aren't even touching the snow. They're just going straight down the hill, and her knees and hips are rotating underneath her. That's what it looks like to me.
Okay. This is great. It's spot on. Yes. The big thing is she is literally falling down the hill. And that's the key, is the sooner you can get off the edge. And this is why we talk, you hear all the time about pressure in the fall line and bend the ski in the fall line. It's about being able to get enough arc to then shoot you across the hill and be able to accelerate as you move from that, from the release point. Because as soon as you release the edge, you're now going to begin to go down the hill. And I think that's a really good way to put it. I talk about that, just falling down the hill. You're now accelerating. You're letting gravity do what it's designed to do until you re-engage the ski. And if you engage the ski early enough, there is no deceleration at all. I often think about trampolines going downhill. If you set trampolines on a steep pitch, angled towards each other at intervals down the hill, across from me, but kind of offset down the hill of each other, you could jump off one trampoline. And when you bounced off that trampoline, gravity would pull you down the hill. You begin to fall, but from jumping off this trampoline would have taken you across the hill, and you'd be able to land on the other trampoline, bounce off that one, begin to fall, hit the next trampoline, bounce off that one, and begin to fall. All that is easier said than done, because it takes an enormous amount of skill. So hopefully that clears it up. So what's happening biomechanically is the legs are turning. That's the big thing. And the pelvis is stable. And we're going to get into the motor skill development a little bit, but that's the important part to understand. And that's the big misconception. And we'll look at another video of stable hips. If you look at the plane of her pelvis right now, as her legs turn and change direction, the skis change direction, her pelvis is not, her right side of her hip, her uphill hip, her right side is staying in alignment. It's staying ahead, and it stays ahead until about this point when the skis begin to contact the snow again. So you'll hear me talk a lot about keeping the uphill pelvis. We use the word hip, but it's really pelvis what we're talking about. Keeping that ahead, keeping it ahead through the transition. So a lot of what's going on with a lot of skiers that don't have this yet developed is as the skis release, this happens. The pelvis, this being down the hill towards the screen, is down the hill. The skier might have some separation. A lot of our guys and girls know how to do that. And so the pelvis is going this way down the hill. And as the skis flatten out, this happens. And if you all take a moment to stand up and do this, I want to know what happens to your left ankle. Our left hip is our uphill side. Right foot downhill side, so right footer. Downhill is this way. What happens to my left ankle when that happens? Here. What happens to my left ankle? If I stay here and change edge, think about that. We're not talking about this plane right now. We're just talking about this plane fore aft here. If I do that with my pelvis versus here, this side stays forward and go that way.
Your left ankle straightens out.
And it's, yes, like, thank you.
Right, you're welcome.
Thank you. Yeah, that's a key element. So what happens is your uphill pelvis actually moves back relative to what is going to be your new outside foot. And we know how important at this point in the time, in the turn, having pressure against the front of the boot. Watch the upper legs rotate to help change the edge and redirect the skis through the transition of the turn.